Hi, this is Shab at LoveToCode.com. Welcome back to another tutorial on Eclipse. In this video, you will learn how to use Eclipse to navigate and search through your source code. We'll cover the following topics. You'll learn how to search and find code. You'll also learn how to find references for a class or method. We'll also discuss how to open a method declaration. And finally, you'll learn how to view the call stack. Okay, so let's get started. A common thing you need to do whenever you're using Java development is searching for strings or searching for text. Eclipse allows you to search by simply using the CTRL F feature, and this brings up the Find and Replace window. So you can type in whatever text that you want to search for, and Eclipse will go through and find it. You can set various options, case sensitive, whole word, and it just works like this works like a normal text editor. So I'm searching for demo, and it'll just walk through and it'll show me all instances for demo in this actual file. If you want to make use of replace, you can say replace the word demo with foobar, and then go through and do a replace find or replace all. And again, it works like a normal text editor. Also, when you have a large code base, you may need to search for text in other files. So other than just the local file, you need to search all of the files in your project. So Eclipse offers a very robust search mechanism. You can search for plain text or Java-specific constructs. To open the search item, select Search, Search. And as you can see, this brings up the search dialog. This search dialog has a lot of information, so let's go through it one piece at a time. There's a file search where you can search for plain text across multiple files. You can give the actual text you're searching for and the file name pattern. You can also search for tasks that are available in Mylan. Mylan is a to-do list or task list item. There's also a Git search. Git is a repository or version control system, and you can search against a repo. And there's also the Java search, where you can search for specific Java constructs like types, packages, or fields, methods, or constructors. All right, so let's try out the Java search. In this example, I want to search for a class that makes use of the JButton class. So I'll set the type here, and I'll say the string I'm searching for is JButton, and that's the actual type. So I'm searching for the JButton that's used in all of the files within this project. I hit search, and at the bottom it gives me the search results. Okay, and so it'll show you all of the files that are making use of JButton, and you can easily expand and explore and drill down and get the actual details for it. All right, another thing I want to do here is I actually want to search by method name. So I want to find methods that begin with a certain string. So over here, I'll just kind of pull this down a bit. I'll go back to my search, and I'll choose search again. This will bring up the search window. I have the Java search. I'm going to search for an actual method name, and I want to find a method name that starts with create. So I'll say create star. Okay, so I'll make use of the wildcard to match on any string, and then I'll hit search. And at the bottom, it'll give me a list again of all of the methods, I'm sorry, all of the classes or files that have a method called create inside of it. So I can go through and I'll see them match there. I'll move down some more and I'll see more matches. Now you may see other methods here referenced. So it means that these methods actually use the create method inside of it. So if I double click on one of these, then I'll go in and see that this method is using a create call accordingly. So just a very nice way of going through and finding all methods that have the name create or calls to methods with the name create. The next feature we'll cover is how to navigate the Java source code as far as drilling down into an actual method. So let's say, for example, you have a line of code, and here we have this JPanel P1 equals create vertical panel. So there's some method that's going to execute and create this panel for us. What exactly does this method do? Well, we can actually open a declaration for the method and find out the actual internal details. So I can highlight this file, I'm sorry, highlight this method, right click, say open declaration, and this will take me to the actual coding for this method. So just a very nice feature to navigate the code by looking at the actual declaration for a given method. Another nice feature is that as you're moving through your code, you may find a given method and you want to find out who's calling that actual method. So we can actually find the references for a method. So what I'll do is I'll move up here. I'll find this method called create horizontal panel. All right, so this is a method defined in the class, but Who's calling this method? Okay, I can find the references by right-clicking, going to Reference, Workspace, and this will show us all of the references, basically who's calling this method in this given workspace. And at the bottom, we'll have search results, and so we have 7 references, and so it'll show us the actual methods, and we can double-click those items and go directly to the code and see how this actual method is being called. One last feature that is very useful in navigating a code base is the call hierarchy. This basically gives you the sequence of method calls that are made for a given method. You can find the call hierarchy by simply right-clicking a method and saying Open Call Hierarchy. So this will give you the actual results here, and if you expand all of the nodes, then you'll eventually see the main method. So basically, to step through it, you have the main method that makes a call to this constructor, which in turn makes a call to add checkboxes. Okay, so this wraps up our discussion. In this video, you learned how to use Eclipse to navigate and search through your source code. Please subscribe to our channel to view more videos on Eclipse and Java. Also, visit our website, lovetocode.com, to download Java source code.